Tonight, keeping high school athletes cool and safe, the state of Tennessee decided today to revise its heat policy, limiting the time athletes stay outside and even what they wear. Fox 13's Jonathan Marshall is live with how else, Jonathan, the TSSAA hopes to protect players as much as they can.
Yeah, Darrell, when athletes are outside in the dog days of summer, workouts can get to dangerous, if not deadly, levels if not monitored. That's why the TSSAA has made changes. I spoke with Houston athletic trainer Tripp Turner. He says heat illness is a threat, but it can be avoided.
The thought of protecting football players from the summer heat may have been mocked back in the day, but things have changed. The TSSAA continues to push forward in this effort with its most recent heat policy.
You know, it limits the amount of time we're outside. Certain conditions apply to what equipment we can wear and that type thing. Mandated breaks for water and that type thing. It's going to be an adjustment for some.
Houston High athletic trainer Tripp Turner says heat illness, which can lead to heat strokes, is a real threat. There are some precautions that can be taken, though.
Heat illness is 100% preventable. That's one thing that is very easily remedied if you have someone out there that's experienced, that recognizes that what's going on early.
Some of the new rules from the TSSAA includes limiting practice to 2 hours. The heat index is between 95 to 99 degrees. Players can only wear helmets, shoulder pads, and shorts at this time. Practice is limited to 1 hour should the heat index land between 100 and 104 degrees. No protective gear can be worn at this point. Outdoor practices can't happen if it's over 105. Even game days are impacted. Games must be postponed at this level unless there is a qualified healthcare professional on site with rapid cooling methods. According to Turner, this is where some schools in the area may be impacted the most.
Because we are unique, there's not a whole lot of us. There is a financial burden that goes with that. Not every school system, you know, can afford the salary.
A cooling method that Houston has on site is a tub that players can sit in when filled with ice.
Cooling the body is relatively easily done. But recognizing the signs and symptoms ahead of time is big.
Now, Turner says some factors that can play a part in heat illness and in avoiding it include making sure players are hydrated, their diets, and clothing while working out in the heat. Live in Collierville, Jonathan Marshall, Fox 13 News.